The liquor to go sales has been a lifeline for many area businesses, but the delivery apps that so many of us are using are hurting. Only News 4's Alexis Zotos is finding out there's an effort to cap those extra fees on your tab.
Sam, that's right. Right now, if you'd like to get some of your favorite food at a restaurant here in downtown or anywhere around the city, your options are to go to the door and pick up curbside, or you can order delivery through one of these apps. But restaurants tell me that the percentage that these apps are taking makes it hard for them to make a profit. The doors remain shut, the patio empty. Taco Circus in South City hit pause on carryout and curbside, the hopes to restart next week.
There's almost a hovering threat of how do we gain customers in this time.
One thing they won't be doing, deliveries through third-party apps like DoorDash, Postmates, and Uber Eats. That's because these services can charge around 30% commission to restaurants.
Our profits hover around 10%, and that's the industry standard on restaurants. So you're looking at, if you were to use one of those companies, you would be losing 20% on each sale. Every $100 in sales, we're losing $20 on it.
That's why Alderwoman Christine Ingracia is filing a bill to cap the fees.
Third-party delivery platform would not be able to charge any more than 5% for each individual menu item. And that helps, again, keep the price low for the customer and then helps the restaurant turn a profit.
Cities like Chicago, Boston, and LA are considering similar policies, as so many restaurants rely solely on delivery and carryout right now.
You know, we would certainly prefer carryout because we actually make all of that money, or dine-in.
Chris Summers owns Gringo and Pie Pizzeria and uses delivery services, saying customers have come to expect ordering with the tap of a finger. He wants the fees cut.
5% would be fantastic because we could absolutely make money on that still. We have negotiated very aggressive rates with these companies, particularly DoorDash, at 15%, while most restaurants would pay closer to 25%. We can make a bit of money at 15%, but nobody makes any money at 25%.
These companies warn if a bill like this goes through, your dinner delivery may cost more. DoorDash telling News 4 tonight it's, quote, concerned that proposals like this will ultimately penalize restaurants, consumers, and delivery drivers, adding that they cut commissions in half for close to 300 restaurants in St. Louis through the month of May. So Christine Ingracia's bill will be introduced this Friday to the Board of Aldermen. And also in St. Louis County, Councilwoman Lisa Clancy said she is also exploring a similar idea, but says it might be a little bit more tricky given the number of municipalities there. Live in downtown, Alexis Otis, News 4.